that we human beings know very well, to numbers that computers can understand. And we're doing this in order to identify services such as web servers and email servers that are online. And it serves as the only link between customers and online businesses and vice versa. So essentially, DNS is one of the very critical infrastructure that is part of all that we do on the internet. Be it e-government services, online services, online banking, e-commerce, social networks, and everything that we know largely depends on DNS for it to work properly. Next slide, please. So in okay, so when we are sending DNS traffic on the internet, we usually have three key important important things that have to consider. The first one would be your machine that will be the stuff is over, and also we have your IP DNS server, which is very classic server, and its goal is to browse the DNS tree from the root until it finds the name servers that are authenticated for the record that you are actually looking for. The sensitive DNSs that are hosting your the service that you're looking for. So the traffic will start from your machine and be sent to the recursive server, and then if the recursive server browse the tree to look for that record until it finds the authoritative name server for the domain that you're looking for, and the answer will be sent back to your machine for you to be able to access the website or the main server that you're looking for. So in the course of doing this, there are quite a number of vulnerabilities that you can encounter. Next slide, please. Between
what's that?
Hello. there are quite a number of DNS vulnerabilities that you can encounter in the course of resolving the name that you're looking for, and this can be a man-in-the-middle attack between your service over and your caching server, or it can be the cache poisoning in your ISP recursive server, or data can be modified in your slave server, and as well as a corrupt data from the zone file. This may be coming from your registry zone file DB. Next slide, please. All right, so the main problem is that the DNS data that is published by the registry may be replaced and passed between the server and the client. And the DNS data that is cached on the ISP DNS server can be manipulated on its way to your machine. In 2008, Dan Kaminsky revealed a bug that revealed a DNS flaw that allows hackers to redirect traffic from the legitimate website to the fake one without a website operator or end user knowing what is going on. And now, this was a big shock to the internet industry. Just imagine you're trying to access your bank website and you are redirected to another site, and your credentials are captured and later on being used to do transfer not aware of. So all these vulnerabilities call for a common speech. And as we speak right now, next slide. As we speak right now, there are quite a number of hackers out there who are using this DNS vulnerability to their advantage. If you may all recall, back in 2011, during the biggest cyber criminal takedown in history, about the ghost click, this was the malware that was developed to take over the DNS service of the users and redirect them to the malicious websites where money has been stolen, and it really affected the internet advertising industry, and it estimated about 4 million machines across the globe were infected in over 100 countries. And the loss that came out from this malicious malware was estimated to be around $14 million. So you can imagine all this money being lost by something that we rely on so much, and something that we can really fix. So end-to-end DNSSEC validation would have avoided this problem, and it would have sorted this problem if all the involved stakeholders in the DNS field would have been involved in validating their DNS records. Next slide, please. So this is where DNSSEC comes in. DNSSEC secures the name that we use to IP addresses that our computers are using. And it's doing this by introducing digital signatures into the DNS to protect this record. So it ensures that the DNS source is authentic, that you are actually communicating with. There are no modification of DNS data in between the server and the client that we are sending the traffic to. So this way, the users of the internet will be sure that they are getting the right information from the right website that they're looking for. And also, it will give comfort to the content providers that there are actually no third party that is modifying their data in between them and their users. And this will automatically add stability and increase stability of the internet. So with the DNSSEC fully deployed, a business can be sure that its customers get modified data and vice versa. So this is one of the key reasons why we should use DNSSEC: increase security on the DNS infrastructure. So as we all see that more and more of our web economy and transactions depend on the internet, and also the cyber security is becoming a major concern for our governments and our businesses and end users. All these people expect us, the registrars, registries, and ISPs, to invest on a strong security measure that are understandable and can be easily usable. Yeah? They don't want to get into the tangle of managing keys and doing all these things. They just want things that are working, and to be sure that the DNS is secure enough for them to do transactions online. This is why it is important that we deploy DNSSEC. For next slide, please. So DNSSEC can make your business stand out from the rest. Say your business is offering DNSSEC, and your competitors are yet to deploy DNSSEC, it's automatically that those who are aware of the importance of DNSSEC will prefer to use your businesses, because when you look at the fundamentals right now, they require that we go for value-based competition over prices. People will ask questions of why am I secure on the internet in this connection? Or instead of asking for how much does it cost. So it's important that we go first and differentiate ourselves from the rest. As the internet also becomes essential to the success and failure of companies, it is important that we migrate to the secure model, yeah, that our users can rely on. And we see that a lot of companies are willingly paying a lot of money to enhance security for their customers through SSL certificates and other solutions that can make sure they're safe. So once these companies realize that DNSSEC can protect their domain against the DNS spoofing, then automatically they will run for the business that is offering them a more secure environment on the internet rather than the ones that are not deploying DNSSEC. So this is why it is important that in today's world, you invest more on securing your services rather than concentrating on other issues. So thank you. Hello?
We're here. We're on the Save Your Business slide. Is that where you are?
Sorry?
Are you on the Save Your Business slide?
Yes, I was talking about, yes, I'm on the Save Your Business. It's unfortunate that I cannot see the slides as they're changing. Save Your Business.
So are there any questions? I think you might have to come speak to the laptop.
Don't speak.
Okay, Simon, I do see a question.
Don't speak to my laptop.
Hi, Simon, Mark here. How many of your domains in Tanzania are assigned? How well is that going? Because I know that you're highly involved in the .tz domain name system.
Thank you, Mark. Currently, we have about 50 signed domain names out of the 10,000 that we have. It's been a struggle getting people to sign the domain, but this is mainly contributed to the technical know-how of our registrar. But we are trying on that path to pass this knowledge to our registrar so that they can see value to DNSSEC and use it as one of their business channels. So we have 50 signed DNS domains.
Okay. I don't see any more questions in the audience, so thank you very much, Simon.
Okay.